Hi, and welcome to the 2-Minute Guru. My name is Daniel Bogdanoff. Stick around to find out why electrical current gets on my nerves. Literally. Electrical current is simply the flow of charge through space, and we measure that in amperes or amps. In electronics, we're typically talking about the flow of electrons and typically through a wire, but in semiconductor physics, we can talk about the flow of holes, which is essentially how a bipolar junction transistor works. And in biology or chemistry, we can talk about the flow of ions, which is essentially how your nerves work. And you've probably heard it said that electricity takes the path of least resistance. And this is true, but it can be a little bit misleading. Just like a river will fork around an island, electricity can take multiple paths depending on what it's encountering. To take that analogy a little further, I've poked some different sized holes in the lid of this water bottle. Now, obviously, current is gonna flow out of both holes, not just the bigger one. Let's take a look. And I'll say that the holes in this water bottle are akin to resistors in your circuit. Now, notice that a lot more water came out of the bigger hole, and obviously there's a lot more water in this glass than in this little glass. This is a lot like how current flows through resistors. More electricity is gonna go through the smaller resistor, the bigger hole, remember the straw analogy from earlier, and less current is gonna flow through the little hole. And it's actually gonna be proportional to the size of the holes or to the values of the resistors. So we can see that electricity does take the path of least resistance, just not exclusively. Let's look at an actual example. I have the function generator of my scope outputting a 10 volt peak-to-peak sine wave, and if I take my clamp on current meter, we can see how much current is flowing through this 200 ohm resistor. And if I look at my measurement, I'm seeing about 46 milliamps of current flowing through this resistor. I should also point out I'm in averaging acquisition mode because clamp on current probes are notoriously noisy. If you don't know what that means, check out my video in season one where I talk about acquisition modes. Now let's see what happens to the current if I keep the voltage the same but add another resistor. Now I've added an identical resistor in parallel, so current is gonna flow equally through both of them. And if I look at my measurements, I'm now seeing about 73 milliamps of current. So you can see that if I half the resistance by putting two resistors in parallel, like we talked about in last video, and provide the same voltage, I'm actually getting twice as much current flowing through these resistors. So you can think of current and resistance like your sink faucet. There's consistent water pressure from the mains, but because the resistance of your sink, the choke valve, is so tight, no current, no water is getting through. As you start to open that up or lower your resistance, you're gonna get more and more current going through your sink. That's all we have time for today. Make sure you subscribe to the Keysight Oscilloscopes YouTube channel so you can see when the next episode comes out. We're gonna be talking about voltage. Thanks for watching. If you have any topics that you want me to cover, please put them in the comments. I'm Daniel Bogdanoff, and I'll see you next time.